Sai Kumar sir.
Madam.
We can proceed our process, sir.
Okay, madam.
Welcome all the participants and you welcome our HOD ma'am.
Okay, madam. Good morning to all the participants present over here, and I personally welcome, and on behalf of the college, I welcome our HOD madam, Dr. V. Tamil Chelvi, Usharani madam, the coordinator of the STTP, Dr. KKT Tyagarajan sir, our academic dean, and Dr. Professor Mahesh Kumar from IIT Madras. And the present STTP is basically on mitigation of power quality issues in distributed generation systems using custom power devices. I think the STTP will provide you a very good knowledge about the various happenings that are taking place in the power system arena in order to mitigate the power system power quality based issues over here. And with the starting of this session, and let me introduce our HOD name is Tamil Chelvi. She is the head of the Department of Electrical Electronics Engineering, and she has been in the teaching profession for the past 25 years. Her areas of interest include renewable energy systems, control system, biomedical engineering, signal processing. She is a lifetime member of ISTE, ISOE, and annual member of IEEE. She has published journals in various international conferences and journals. She is recognized as the reviewer of INSC journals. I request our HOD to kindly provide the introduction.
Ma'am, excuse me, sorry, ma'am. 1 minute, ma'am. Sai Kumar, sir, presentation, inaugural presentation, kindly put, sir. Inaugural PPT, sir.
Okay, madam, okay.
Professor Mahesh, sir, inauguration chief guest, that slide you put it, sir.
Okay, madam.
Ma'am, kindly continue, ma'am. I welcome you, ma'am.
Okay. Good morning to one and all present here. On behalf of our management, principal sir, and our academic dean and academic dean research, we are welcoming you all for this STTP program. And you know, this STTP is AECT sponsored program, and this STTP, we received the fund before the pandemic period, but we could not conduct during that period. So AECT gave the permission to conduct this STTP in three phases. Already we have conducted two phases in the July month and August month, and this is the third phase of this STTP. And you know, the STTP title is mitigation on power quality issues. That is the latest topic related to our department. So I hope that all the participants will be having a good enhancement on this topic, and you can have the very good knowledge about this topic. And on behalf of our department, I would like to welcome our Dean Academic Dr. KK Tyagarajan for inaugurating this function STTP program, and welcome you, sir. I would like to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Professor Mahesh Kumar from IIT Madras. In spite of his busy schedule, he accepted our invitation for presenting this session, first session in our STTP program. Welcome you, sir. And I would like to welcome all the participants once again for this program. Thank you.
Let me just provide. Okay, thank you, madam. Thank you for your speech. Let me just provide the agenda of the STTP that is going to take place between 14th to 19th today. So I provide a very warm welcome to all the participants and dignitaries, and let me just provide you. So this is a agenda of our 6 days STTP, and this is the instruction to the participants. The feedback link will be circulated at the end of each session on each day, and on a sixth day an online test will be conducted. After successful part completion of the test, the participants will be receiving their certificate through registered mail ID, and the participants are requested to avoid posting their personal identity in the chat box. This is a set of instruction to be followed by all the candidates, and I personally welcome our chief guest of the session, Dr. Professor Mahesh Kumar from IIT Madras. And these are all the set of eminent speakers who will be taking over the session. This is the set of Dr. P. Somasundaram, Anna University professor. Dr. G. Uma, professor from Anna University, Chennai. Dr. Mahesh Kumar, professor from IIT Madras. Dr. Premalata Jena, associate professor from IIT Roorkee. Dr. M. P. Selvan, associate professor from NIT Trichy. Dr. C. Sharmila, associate professor, Anna University, Chennai. Dr. G. Balamurali, executive engineer, Tantransco, Chennai. Dr. K. Vijay Kumar, associate professor, IIT DM, Kanchipuram. Dr. M. G. Uma Maheshwari, professor, REC, Chennai. So these are the eminent speakers who will be presiding over the sessions for each of the days. And today, as far as today, we'll be having the session between 10:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. on the topic.
Sir, Sai Kumar sir, kindly you I'll start proceeding, sir. You kindly call me, sir.
Enna madam pannu
sir, you kindly tell me, sir, for regarding about STTP, and that I'll speak, sir, because
okay madam
sir is waiting, sir.
Okay madam,
I asked you to share the slides, sir.
Okay madam, I kindly ask Professor Dr. Usha Rani madam to kindly provide the introduction session and provide the further information on the STTP.
Sai Kumar sir, you need to present the slide, sir.
Sir, Usha Rani madam told she will be presiding over the slide, sir.
No, okay, sir, okay. You just keep the slide, sir.
You
okay, sure? Just keep it, madam. It is being displayed, okay, madam.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
It's not available, sir. Sai Kumar sir, it's not displaying.
It's not displaying, sir.
Yeah, that is why it's not displaying. Even the resource person what you mentioned is not displayed. So kindly display the STTP main PowerPoint. From
no,
now
sir.
On, the, ma'am will take over. Now it's visible. Put it in the full screen mode, sir. That is
okay, sir.
Presentation mode. Yeah. No, go back to the first slide, sir. Ma'am will take up. Ma'am will announce. Yeah.
Okay,
ma'am, you can take over it, ma'am.
Good morning to all faculty members, respected principal sir, respected Colonel B. Venkat, Director, Faculty Development, AACTE, respected chief guest of today's function, Professor Dr. Mahesh Kumar, Professor IIT Madras, respected Dean sir, respected HOD, dear faculty members and dear participants, good morning to one and all. First, I wish to thank our honorable chairman sir and beloved vice chairman sir for having given permission and facilities to arrange this online 6 days STTP. I thank AACTE for sponsoring this program. I thank our principal, who is the source of inspiration for all of us. His constant encouragement and guidance made us to host events like this without difficulty. I invite Professor Dean Academic sir for this inaugural session. I extend my sincere thanks to our HOD for guiding and motivating us in each and every part of this event. It is a great honor and privilege for me to introduce our chief guest of today's function, Professor Dr. Mahesh Kumar, IIT Madras, to the participants. It is a pride moment for all of us to have such an eminent academician amongst us for inaugurating this AACTE-sponsored STTP. We are grateful to you, Professor, for accepting our invitation in spite of your busy schedule. On behalf of our management, our college, on my own behalf, I welcome you, sir. Professor Mahesh K. Mishra received his B.Tech degree from the College of Technology, Patnagar, India in 1991, M.E. degree from IIT Roorkee, 1993, and Ph.D. degree from IIT Kanpur, 2002, in electrical engineering. He has about 28 years of teaching and research experience for about 10 years. He was with the Department of Electrical Engineering, Vishwesharaya National Institute of Technology, Nagpur, India. He is currently a professor with the Department of Electrical Engineering, IIT Madras, Chennai, India. His research interests include the areas of power distribution systems, power electronics, microgrids, and renewable energy systems. Professor Mahesh has completed a dozen of sponsored research projects and consultancies. Under his research supervision, about 18 PhD, 12 MS, and 50 MTech students have been awarded. Professor Mahesh and his scholars have been awarded many international, national, and institute level awards. He has around 250 research publications in international and national peer-reviewed journals and conferences. He has written an NPTEL web book on power quality in power distribution systems, concepts and applications. Professor Mahesh is a life member of Indian Society of Technical Education. He received the IETE Professor Bimal Bose Award in 2015 for his outstanding contributions to power electronic applications in power systems. He serves has served as an editor for the IEEE Transactions on Sustainable Energy. In November 2017, he has been elected as Fellow of Indian National Academy of Engineering. I once again welcome you, Professor. Let me brief about STTP. The title is Mitigation of Power Quality Issues in Distributed Generation Systems Using Custom Power Devices. The motto behind organizing such programs is to strengthen the teaching learning process. You know, your power quality is the ability to create a perfect power supply that a pure sinusoidal, noise-free wave shape and is always stable if voltage and frequency is considered. Practically, many nonlinear loads include rectifiers, adjustable speed drives, electronic devices such as computers, printers, TVs, servers, and telecoms. The increasing applications of distribution generation, switch mode power converters, drives, and rapidly changing loads all have contributed to influence the system power quality. Distributed power generation systems are needed to address the following issues. With a decrement of 12.3% in peak demand, DGS can reduce the peak demand. High transmission and distribution losses there in India, approximately 35% as per CEA record. In many parts of our country, extension of grid may not be the remote and inaccessible areas. So in that case, DGS plays a major role. Rural electrification is possible. Faster response to new power demands. Improved supply reliability and power quality. Possibility of better energy and load management. We are trying to cover most of the thrust areas of power quality by inviting eminent academicians and industrialists from IITs, NITs, Anna University, TNEB. The 6 days program will enhance your knowledge and skill on impact of power quality issues. Today morning, we'll be having Professor Dr. Mahesh sir will be handling the session, followed by the inaugural afternoon section, Professor Somasundaram from Anna University. Day two, Dr. M.P. Selvam sir, NIT Trichy. Afternoon section, Dr. G. Uma ma'am, Professor Anna University. Day three, Dr. C. Sharmila madam, Anna University. Afternoon section, we'll be having virtual training by Fluke. It will be conducted by LMAC Engineering Services. Day four, Dr. Vijay Kumar sir, IITDM, Kanjipuram. Afternoon section, Dr. G. Balamurali, TAN Transco, Executive Engineer. Day five, Dr. Uma Maheshwari, Professor REC. Afternoon section, virtual training by Fluke LMAC Engineering Services by Mr. Jyoti Prakash. Last day, morning session, Dr. Premlata Jana Madam, IIT Roorkee. Afternoon section will be having online assessment and followed by valedictory. We have successfully completed STTP 1 by inaugurated by Engineer Thirumurthy sir in the month of July, and the STTP 2 in the month of August, inaugurated by Professor Dr. Bhim Singh, IIT Delhi Professor. with the help of the participants' support only, we have conducted approximately 118 participants attended for STTP 1, and 104 participants attended STTP 2. Now, for this STTP 3, we have 160 participants registered. Tamil Nadu 80 and other states like Assam, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Tripura, Uttarakhand, Kerala, Karnataka, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, 80 participants. I thank all the participants for registering this STTP. We assure you that this 6 days STTP will enhance your skills and knowledge in the thrust areas. Now let me say a few points. At the end of this each section, we'll be posting the feedback link in the chat box. Kindly use your official mail ID. On the 60-day online test, it is mandatory to conduct as per the norms of ASCPE. E-certificate will be sent to your college official mail ID. The learned Acharya Chanakya says that education is the best friend. An educated person is respected everywhere, and we gather each drop of water filling the pot. The same way, we must accumulate more and more knowledge. In the long term, this builds into a massive treasure which benefits us all through life. I take this opportunity to thank organizing committee members Dr. Srivatsan, Mr. Praveen Kumar Reddy, Mr. Sai Kumar, and all other faculty members of our department. I thank Almighty for having good health during this pandemic period for all. I wish you all the best. Thank you all. I once again welcome Professor Mahesh sir, and our Dean sir, our HOD madam, and all participants. Thank you.
Thank you, madam, for providing a debrief of the various sessions that are going to take place on these 6 days. Next, I request Mr. Dr. Thyagarajan sir to preside over the session to provide the introduction.
So, thank you, sir. Good morning to all of you. I would like to give a brief introduction of our college and this STTP. RMD Engineering College was established in the year 2001 by our chairman, Sri R.S. Muniratnam, who is renowned for his philanthropic attitude and service. RMD Engineering College has entered into memorandum of understanding with several industries and institutions, and we have established centers of excellence in various latest technical fields for enhancing the technical skills of our students. This has made Electrical Engineering Department as one of the shortlisted departments for final stage of evaluation by AICTE and Confederation of Indian Industries consecutively for the last 2 years all over India. I congratulate the head of the department, the professors, and all the faculty members who are the backbone of this achievement. We are also proud to inform you that RMD Engineering College was conferred with the prestigious Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan National Award for an engineering college having best overall performance by Indian Society of Technical Education. The EEE department is also organizing many programs for students and faculty members very enthusiastically. They are conducting 3 short-term programs for the faculty members during this pandemic period. This STTP is the 3rd one. On this occasion, I thank Professor Mahesh Kumar, IIT Madras, for accepting our invitation and deliver inaugural address. He is the most suitable person for inaugurating this program, and he is a dedicated expert in power quality management. His NPTEL video lectures and web courses are very popular. Thank you, sir, for taking part in our program. India is the 3rd largest producer and consumer of electricity. India has the 4th largest installed wind power capacity in the world. We should be proud about our state. The largest wind power generating state is Tamil Nadu in our country. Continuous urbanization and the growth of population result in increased power consumption in buildings. electricity driven vehicles are expected to become popular in India in near future. So the power requirement in our country is always increasing. The national electric grid in India has an installed capacity of 372 gigawatts as on August 2020. India has a surplus power generation capacity but lacks adequate distribution infrastructure. The solar energy sector in India offers potentially enormous capacity, though little of this potential has so far been exploited. Integrating all these power generation sources and maintaining the quality of the power distribution is really a challenging one. The latest power electronic converters help us in this case. Nowadays, almost all households have access to electricity. However, most households find the electricity supply intermittent and unreliable. Transmission, distribution, and consumer level losses exceed 30% in our country. I believe that at the end of this short-term training program, all the participants will get additional knowledge on distributed power generation sources, various power electronic devices and interfaces available to improve the power quality. I appreciate the head of the department, Dr. Tamilselvi, coordinator, Dr. Usharani, organizing committee members, Dr. Rangarajan, Dr. Srivatsan, Mr. Praveen Kumar and Mr. Sai Kumar, all technical committee members and all faculty members for taking a lot of effort in organizing these short-term technical programs. I wish the program to be successful. Have a nice time. Thank you.
Thank you for your imminent and inspiring, energizing speech, sir. And I request Dr. Professor Mahesh Kumar to provide the introductory speech.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Audible. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So thank you very much for your kind introduction. Dr. Usharani and her team, principal, HOD Tamilselvi, principal, and Dean Thyagarajan ji. So thank you very much for this opportunity to interact the faculty members. I was thinking that it is for students as well, but anyway, it's okay. I have prepared from that perspective, but anyway, this could be a general discussion. So I again thank you for having this technical activity for faculty members all over the country. I think it's a good use of time in this difficult period of the, you know, the corona and the corona pandemic. And we can use this time for interactions, for understanding those deeper concepts regarding the power quality and their applications. I feel that it is time to rather change, transform in our education system, in our way of thinking, in our way of implementing. So for example, we could be good theoreticians, we could be good lecturers, but when it comes to the implementation, we have not been that successful as a community. So what I am saying that these things, concept, particularly power quality, is not very commercial and very much technical activity in our Indian electrical scenario. It's mostly remain on paper or research problems. That is true for everyone, including me, as well as others. But what we need to do is more towards the, you know, implementation, coming with some, you know, practical products for day-to-day applications. Okay, particularly it's become more useful when it comes to the microgrid systems, which is taking a lot of impulse in our electrical engineering or electrical scenario, electrical generations, because we have to interface various renewable sources and a lot of power electronics is there. So which creates some more problems like harmonics, switching components, okay, which need to be filtered before you connect to the grid. So there are additional challenges that have to be looked for. Also, from student point of view, I feel that we should be more, you know, project-based kind of a courses rather than the just simply theory-based courses. That anyway, I think you will be hearing that the from Prime Minister's side, there is a significant change in the educational transformations, changes, which has come, I think, last week, from primary to the high school. There are very transformational changes, which will put emphasis on understanding, insightfulness, rather than simply claiming and bringing marks. Okay, so what I'm saying that the education system in our country is really not in good shape from starting from primary to the, you know, higher classes. Mostly we depend upon the mugging, remembering, and then higher marks, the society perception of getting the highest marks, ranks, all those things. They are not going to help in long term to this humanity. This is my feeling, personal feeling. We should be more, thorough and more thoughtful in everything we touch, we do, we feel. So we should think everything in form of products, usefulness of certain ideas, concepts, that will really be very helpful. However, topic is quite good because the power quality and awareness is quite contextual to our country, where we already have not much generations, we are not having abundant generations, so we have to save in whatever way we can do. Some basic step like switching off when you go outside, you're turning off your computer devices, having the main switch everywhere, they will almost solve 10% saving in our power quality aspect. And then comes the advanced devices like custom power and so on and so on. Okay, but before I go for this, I maybe take a few minutes more. Maybe this is not for you. I think most of us follow certain quite disciplined life in being a lecturer or being a professor. But for our students and in general for our common people, I'll just share one slide. I have a slightly sometimes bad experience in terms of society, the way we live, the discipline, the traffic on the road, the way they behave. It's not well thought, not well conscious thought. So I will put the slides, don't think as a kind of a preaching or something. It is just for our better changes. What I'm saying, this time is okay because in this last 5-6 months, the nature got enough rest in the name of Corona, you can say. Okay, although we have suffered a lot as a business for common person, for a person on the street or those who are small companies, they have a significant loss, but somehow nature has been, you know, getting a lot of rest and a lot of recovery in terms of the, the rain or crops. Okay, the naturalness, the fresh air, all those things have come to perhaps to some recovery. So I'll just have the sharing of this slide. It is off track, but it is useful in general. So maybe you may give to the students when they come here. I will just share it. Where is my slide? Do you see?
Yes, sir, it's visible, sir.
Okay. Whenever I take class in my student classes, I also use this. But it is in general, let us not take as a preaching or something. I feel this will change significantly. What I am worried, when the pandemic is over and people will come first on the roads and other things, we will have same madness. So perhaps we can reduce this madness by following certain, how to make it big size, control L. Okay. So what I'm saying that we are among the highest population density of large size countries, and therefore this is strongest reason to be disciplined in every act and every thought, whatever we do. For example, when we talk or when we walk, we should maintain some kind of a discipline. Generally, I have seen people obstructing the main passages like door or like road I have seen even, I have gone to my kids' school, all teachers will stand in front of the door and nobody can enter. So they never think that whether it is useful or not. Okay. So the obstruction, we should not allow obstruction. We should stand by side of the road or passage and then allow people to flow. So we never think about this, but I hope we can give some more conscious thought at institute level, at school level. And second thing, when we talk to our group, perhaps our students or our friends, we should be a little soft and use a decent throat or amplifier volume if we are using the electronic instrument. And definitely, shouting, disturbing noise, this kind of things should be minimized to create more space, more constructive space for people to work and to invent and to explore, particularly in academic as well as non-academic atmosphere. Also, when we travel on the road, two-wheelers, four-wheelers, we should exercise some virtue of patience and stop honking. I generally observe when I go on the road, people are just mad and they keep on honking on each other for no reason at all. In Western countries, due to strict laws, the honking is allowed only for abnormal conditions. Something is very wrong. Somebody is in danger. Then they only honk. But in our country, it is, you know, normal. In the normal things, we keep on honking without any restrictions. So that habit has to go. We can spread among our students, our friends, other things. And also, I have seen that parking sense is missing among the Indian minds. They say they park like anything, you know, tilted this, that way. And normally they block the passes. So this consciousness has to come that we should be thoughtful in every act. Littering, plastic covers, wrappers, spitting, all the things are very common in our society. Somehow, there's a lot of effort from government side, but I don't think it is working. I mean, people are still seeing, I have people seeing, using, eating and throwing on the road itself in front of me. We cannot help. So this, I think, has to go away. And also, we should be more thoughtful. Like, we should, one more thing, that we should think of others as well. Generally, we Indians take things granted. So that is a thing. So there are general things we can pass on our students and those people who generally, you know, skip those things. So this is in general. So I hope this will be a good message to bring more discipline when we come back after this pandemic, because the madness definitely will come back. So with this, I will stop, and I wish all the best for our faculty members for this program. I definitely feel that it will be quite useful. The speakers are quite eminent in this area of power quality and their applications in power system. We will learn many conceptual things, and I wish all the best for all participants. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your very much inspiring speech about providing the things to be followed by all the people. A mental discipline is required for leading a very good life. And I thank you personally for all the eminent personalities who provided the introduction about the STTP. Thank you.
Sir, Professor Mahesh, sir. So I request you to, can you handle the session now, or we can have a 5 minutes break, sir?
Yeah, 5 minutes break. Yeah, 5 minutes break. I will take, I'll come back.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
I request all the participants.
Thank you, Dean, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, once again, thank you, Dean, sir, and thank you, HOD, ma'am, for your valuable time you have spent.
Okay, madam. Thank you, madam.
Thank you. We request, Sai Kumar, will you make the announcement, Sai Kumar?
I request all the participants to be kindly in the session. Do not leave the session, as the speaker is to start the session in a couple of minutes.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Professor Mahesh.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, HOD, madam. Thank you, KKT, sir. Thank you, sir, Academic Dean, sir, for gracing the occasion. Thank you, sir.
We request participants to stay put. The session will begin in a couple of minutes. Dr. Mahesh Kumar sir will take the session.
Participants, don't kindly leave the session. Please do stay in the session. The session will be started in a couple of minutes.
Dear participants, at the end of each session, morning and afternoon, we'll post the feedback link in the chat box only. Kindly submit the link using your official college mail ID. I welcome Professor Dr. Mahesh Kumar sir.
Yeah.
For the first session, one title, power quality in power distribution system. I request professor to handle the session, sir. Kindly, sir.
The screen is visible now.
Sir, it's visible, sir.
Sir.
My voice is coming?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. It's audible, sir.
Okay, thank you. So I today will discuss some basic aspects of power quality in power distribution network. Not really in much detail, but just conceptual aspects. Most of you will be aware of those concepts, and I think you have a very interesting topic coming in the next few days. And power quality in wind systems or microgrid systems. Okay, so all these will be connecting to each other, and I hope this will be the most connecting lecture that you can correlate to others coming also. So I will just have a brief introduction how it started, all this business of power quality. If you remember the history of the development of electrical power system,
It starts around 1880s when the DC system was invented by Edison. Around 1880s, the topmost at that time, and they constructed a DC transmission line at about 110 volt. And they were expecting that all over the world, the DC system will flourish in the advocacy of the Edison. But at the same time, the Nikola Tesla, who was electrical engineer, around same time, he was quite junior to Edison actually. But there was tough competition later on. In fact, he worked in the company of Edison. But later on, he became the rival and he just come out of that particular company. And he invented the AC machine system, AC machinery three-phase systems. Before that, transformer was already invented. So it laid down the perfect ground for the invention of the electrical AC electrical power system. So you know that in DC power system, it's very simple power system. It has simple equations and it won't involve the difficult concepts of harmonic power, reactive power, so and so on. It is B is equal to IR, and in the steady state, there is no drop across the inductance. L divided by dt is equal to zero, and in the steady state, the capacitor holds all the voltage. So simple things were there. And as you know, the AC power system is slightly more complicated, but it has been spreading all over the world for simple reason that it has a more flexibility. So it's, you can say, a flexible power system because it provides a significant flexibility in terms of voltage and currents. And that happens through transformer. So transformer is the backbone of the complete development of AC power system. So with the help of transformer, the engineer could transform the voltage up and down depending upon the uses. For example, if they have to transmit the huge bulk power over long length of lines, then AC power system is the best because they will first step up the voltage, and as a virtue of that, the current will come down. Okay, so that will reduce the power losses over the transmission line and make it more efficient, make it more obvious choice for the transmission of electricity. Now, why transmission? As you know, that we could not consume all the electricity at the point of generation. So we have to definitely transmit the power over long length of lines. That is the basic important thing in the AC power system. Otherwise, it's not useful. So we generate the power where there are enough resources, maybe coal, maybe oil, maybe the water, hydroelectric plants, maybe nuclear. And then from that center, called generation center, we step up the voltage and supply the electricity to remote far away areas through the transmission line at very high voltage, maybe in few hundreds of kilovolt, 400 kilovolt, 800 kilovolt, so and so on. So that is the starting point of AC power system, the flexibility and reducing the losses, transmitting power over the large length of lines. But at the same time, it developed many problems. It is much more complicated than DC power system. For example, the reactive power, the real power, the harmonics, and the blackout, the brownout, the stability, subharmonics, subsynchronous resonance, resonance phenomena. Many problems were there. In spite of those problems, the AC power system flourished all over the world. For simple reason, it has a more flexibility and it could be used to transmit the power over long length without much significant loss. And also an interesting point that the pooling up, you can pool the different generations through one frequency, one voltage, roughly. Okay, so transmission like 9 voltage. So the possibility of pooling the different generations through transmission network and then arranging the power to flow wherever it is required is one of the most beautiful characteristics of AC power system. This also reduces the cost of generation, because cost depends upon the resources and their availability and the people who work for the system. So specializing where it has to be generated, where it has to be consumed, how long it has to be transmitted, will finally reduce the cost, because all generations are being pulled up. However, as I said, this creates one problems, and these problems led to the another aspect of the power system called power quality. So how these problems can be solved at generation level, at distribution level, at transmission level, each has a different distinct features. Transmission has different problems, generation has a different problems in terms of power quality, and distribution has different problems. So I will mostly focus on the distribution side. Okay, now just to make it very clear that there are two kinds of the power quality devices which are used to handle or the address the improving the power quality in power system. The one group is called the FACTS device. Okay, so FACTS device is basically for transmission system. Flexible AC transmission systems. And they are high power semiconductor devices are used, for example, thyristors, GTOs, to realize the series and shunt compensating devices.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, the PPT is small, sir. Size is small, sir.
Size is small, sir. No, Saikumar, sir. It's visible, sir. Visible, sir. Fine, sir.
Okay, sir.
I have a full screen. I do not know. I can.
Yeah, no. Fine, sir. It's fine, sir. No issues, sir.
Okay. I will send anyway later on slides to PDF version to you. You can have.
Yes, sir. Okay. You can continue, sir. You can continue, sir. Thank you, sir.
I have completely the full version here, full screen.
Yes, sir. You can continue, sir.
And then custom power devices are used for distribution systems. They also use power electronic devices, but they are at different ratings. Their voltage and current ratings is far less than the FACTS devices, because FACTS has to handle the transmission network and the custom power has to handle the distribution network. For example, there could be GTUs and thyristors in case of FACTS device. In case of custom power device, we can have a MOSFETs and the IGBTs. Okay, so that difference. Another difference in the two devices is that the FACTS devices may not operate at very high switching frequency, while custom power devices can operate at very high switching frequency, like some few, you know, tens of kilohertz, 10 kilohertz, 20 kilohertz, because current rating is less and voltage rating is also less. So they could be operated at the higher switching frequency to cancel, to nullify the harmonics. You need more speed. So harmonics and the other disturbances are the main aspect in custom power devices. Reliability of the supply to the equipment at low level, at medium level, and so on. But idea is same. The idea is to use power electronic device to modulate the voltage and current through variable inductance or capacitance or reactance in general by electronically switching it. So most of you will be aware of, as all of your faculty will be teaching all those courses. So this is the basic difference between the FACTS and custom power devices to address the power quality issues. Now, coming to the distribution side, as I said, the FACTS and custom power devices. So these custom power devices, or you can say controllers, power electronic controllers, you can also say, they basically consist of nothing but converters. Okay. So converter basically means inside there are static switches like MOSFETs, could be the IGBTs, VGTs, and so on and so on, injection transformers, master control modules, energy storage devices like DC storage, and then their ability to perform the current interruptions and voltage regulations to satisfy the quality requirement. And you also will be aware that these custom power devices can broadly be classified into two main categories, Sunt and Series, okay? And then could be hybrid Sunt and Series. So broadly speaking, there are only two coins, Sunt type and Series type. Okay, so Sun type, if you consider, okay, the main idea of all these devices at the custom power level, means the distribution power side, are mostly about the power factor corrections, the harmonic elimination, unbalanced load mitigation, the voltage sag and swell interruptions, mitigations, transient mitigation, flicker mitigation. Okay, these are the main you can say aspects that has to be looked in the distribution network. Okay, so with this, as I discuss the about classification, so two main aspects are the Sun devices and Series devices. You can see it here. Okay, this is the Sun here and this is the Series here. So they are the main categories. In fact, you all devices in our power system, we can define in terms of the, these two broad classifications, Sunt and Series. So obviously, Sunt means that we are concerned about connecting something in Sunt with the load. Okay, and the main objective in the Sunt connection type of compensation are the load balancing, the power factor correction, harmonic elimination. Voltage regulation is the last one, because voltage regulation is not the direct control by the Sun device. It's indirect control. The direct control is current regulation, in fact. The first one, the load, we call it load balancing, or you can say the current regulation, you can say. So load balancing and power factor correction, the first two headings, they basically part of the current regulation. And harmonic elimination also part of this, but voltage regulation is the consequence of the current regulation. It's not direct parameter which is being controlled by a Sun device. And these are normally called D state comp, because D for distribution side. So state comp means static compensator, which consists of the static devices like IGBT and MOSFETs. So the generally we call Sun devices as D state comp, and whose function is to balance the load, power factor correction, harmonic elimination, and voltage regulation. Now, contrary to this is called Series devices. The Series device, the direct control parameter is voltage, because they are connected in series, so the voltage is being directly controlled. In case of the Sunt, the current is directly controlled. This is a basic difference. And even you go for microgrid systems, you will see that the inverter which you use, the inverter that we use in microgrid system can be either in a current control mode or in a voltage control mode. The current control mode basically called grid interruptive mode, because the grid voltage is already there at point of common coupling. The grid point is already there, so we have to connect to that common point. So basically the voltage point is provided by the grid, so we can only inject currents, we cannot change voltage. And if you have a standalone mode of the microgrid, in that case only voltage is generated, because there is no question of current, because there is no other source for voltage. Grid is not there. So these two also corresponds to the current control mode. Sun devices corresponds to the current control mode, and the Series device corresponds to the voltage control mode. I think this is to be very clear from the definition. Okay. This again, you are aware of this. In D state comp also there are different configurations, passive and active. So when you say D state comp, basically it means active only. So active means the active power filter, and active power filter basically again means the custom power devices. So this, if you see, consists of the active power device called voltage source inverter, supported by a DC link, and the controlling of this voltage source inverter. In passive, we have simply combination of L and C. In the beginning, when the issue of addressing the balancing the load came, people use the passive filters. They use the different kind of L and C combinations to handle the reactive power and to maintain the unity power factor at the point of common coupling. This is still used in many companies and industries where they use the bank of capacitors to address the power factor issue. Just 1 minute.
Send mail and his beliefs and meeting. Okay, yeah. Afternoon, you call me. Okay.
Sorry for interruption. So, but passive has some drawback, as you know, because each frequency needs some L and C. So if you have many harmonics, it's very difficult to have this bulky things, particularly when the space is a limitations. Therefore, if we have enough to make it, then enough money to facilitate, the active power filters are better choices for the given space and the controllability, the adaptability to different situations in the load compositions. Okay. So, and with this also, we have, so in this passive, in this active filtering or active power filters, this voltage source inverter actually plays a significant role. Okay. Because this is the heart of the active power filter, whether it is a registered COM or it's a DBR or it's a UPQC or it is a sine switch device. So this BSI plays a significant role. And depending upon the BSI, we have different configurations, different topology that makes the one of the important aspect in the load compensation. For example, we can use the voltage source inverter, we can use the current source inverter as a starting point for this compensation. And depending upon the application and the usage, efficiency, easiness, we can choose. But as you might be knowing, that voltage source inverters are more common because they're easily available to us and they're quite efficient in operation, okay, as compared to the current controller inverters, where we use inductance as the source device, as energy storage, and in case of the voltage, we use the capacitors as energy storage device. But remember, the energy storage is not in the sense that we have to use the huge energy to support the system. It is just a one buffer source to provide the operation in transient periods. Rest, its function is just a presence. The DC must be there. The losses are quite smaller in all the active power filters except the switching devices. There's no real energy is being consumed in this, these inverters. Okay, so because of the higher losses and higher initial costs, CSI based topologies are not preferred. Mostly we use the voltage source inverter topologies. Now in this voltage source inverter topologies, we have a different configurations, like we can have a single phase configurations, three phase configurations. In three phase, we may have a star and delta connections, okay? And also we can classify these active power filters based on the shunt series, shunt end series, and hybrid active power filters, or you can say unified power quality conditions as well. Then BSI, CSI, sometimes their hybrid combinations. So there are different classifications. Now once more, I will just focus on those aspects. There's the shunt end series active power filter. So you can see from the diagram, it's very clear that in case of the shunt active power filter, we are injecting the powers through the current. So this is also called the active power filter in a current control mode, because we are controlling the current IF. IF is the F for filter. So by switching this VSI supported by a DC link, we inject a current IF in such a way that it satisfies the need of the compensation. For example, the reactive power requirements, it could be a harmonic cancellation. In case of series, we have this topology where we have a transformer as the main device through which we induce the voltage in series with the load. So primary is being controlled by the VSI, and the primary controlling generates the induced EMF in the secondary, which satisfies our requirement of the compensation. Okay, so that is the series. Now, hybrid is combination of the passive filter and active filter. It's called hybrid power active filter. So hybrid basically means that we are combinations of the tuned passive filter plus the active filter. And as you know, the unified power quality conditioner is nothing but the combination of the shunt and series. You can see it here. There are two inverters back to back here, and they are supported by a DC link voltage. The DC link is common, and the one filter is using the current injection here, and the another filter is injecting the voltage injection. So this will address the power quality related to the regulation of voltage and current both. Okay, and the only thing is that it is quite complicated, because there is one DC link and sharing the active reactive powers, so control is complicated, but it can solve the two problems in one shot, that is voltage and current related problems. Now the design of the DC link has to be very carefully done here, because the requirement for the D-state COM, the requirement for the DBR is different. So it is a challenge that how to choose the DC link voltage to address the satisfactory operation of the both the devices. At the same time, if you see the series active filter, okay, the requirement is that how much sag or how much swell we want to compensate. But in case of the shunt, the requirement is to maintain the quality of the current which is going into the load. All right, so the requirement is different. That's why the DC link design becomes more difficult. And we can also interchange their positions. So for example, the shunt could be here and this could be here. So this is called actually right shunt topology, because shunt is in the right. If you use this side, it's called left shunt topology. And they have their own pros and cons. I think you can refer Professor Ghosh's book that describes more in detail these comparative studies of different configurations of the FPQC. Okay, now in all these aspects, so once comes like topology, the arrangement, the different classifications depending upon the applications. The next important point, this is called hardware or experimental, or this is say the real side of the active power filter, where we do use the real inverter and its supporting DC link and the filter components like L and C, which helps to shape the desired current or voltage to be injected in the system to have a desired power quality. But beyond all those things, we have a theoretical aspect as well. What is the theoretical aspect? Theoretical aspect is this. This is called mathematical aspect or theoretical aspect, or you can say this is the conceptual aspect, which gives us idea that what voltage or what current have to be generated or injected. So this is a kind of a signal processing problem actually. So basically signal processing means that for a given parameters of voltage and current in the system, what is the reference quantity that has to be injected? Okay, so this needs some algorithms, some basic theory, or some kind of a formulation that led to the extraction of, or the estimation of, or the synthesization of the reference voltage and current parameters in the power system to compensate the desired components of power. There are many, like averaging and sampling techniques, the fast Fourier transform techniques, the capacitor error voltage and PI controller technique, instantaneous reactive power theory. I think some more popular, most of you might be knowing this concept by Akagi, generalized reactive power theory, and theory of symmetrical component, the theory of synchronous reference frame. I am not added here, we can add that also. Basically, if I, the first three are just a, you know, pure signal processing, almost 50 is pure signal processing, that you first find out the Fourier transform and see which are undesired components of power and therefore current and voltages which have to be compensated. Okay, and the third one is simply based on the DC link voltage, just monitor the DC link voltage and use some compensation. The next three are the real, you know, control theories which are used for the control of the filter, active filter. Okay, we're going to add one more. Generalized reactive power theory is same as instantaneous reactive power theory. It's not different, it is much more generalized. And theory of symmetrical component is another concept, and the theory of the synchronous control theory, synchronous components is another, D and Q components. So there are three are generic, PQ, DQ, and symmetrical. I have given more details in my power quality book. Maybe you can refer that. But I will just describe briefly what that means, what is the meaning of these control theories. Okay, so the main idea of the control theory is therefore to generate the reference quantities. I said, like, this is an ideal three-phase four-wire compensator. So you can see the configuration is three-phase four-wire, which is normally in distribution side we have. In distribution side, we have a earth wire coming from the load side, from the building, from the plant, and this earth wire is grounded somewhere. Okay, maybe it is finally connected to the earth wire, the ground wire of the tower, and tower has a running of the neutral wire. So finally, this neutral wire, first comes the neutral wire, then it is grounded, or it is connected to the ground of the tower. And the tower carries its own earth wire finally to go to the substation. So this is a very common configuration. Okay, the whole idea is this, that these loads could be unbalanced, they may have a non-linearity, they may be switched waveform, but I do not want these components to come from the source, this side. Do you see my cursor? Are you able to see my cursor?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the source side, and here I do not, we as engineer do not want that the undesired component should flow from this side. So what we want, those undesired component should be circulating between these points here. And only desired component must come from the source side. Now, what is the desired component? The desired component is nothing but the fundamental balanced three phase sine currents. Okay, for example, if you look this side here, okay, then I don't know, it's not activated. This side here, then we have only ISA1, ISB1, ISC1, and they must be either in phase or they must have certain specific power angle or power factor relationship with the voltages. All other components should be the understanding between this filter and this load. Okay, so all active power, all harmonics will flow between these units. What will be here? We will have only the fundamental balanced three-phase components in relation with the voltages. So what should be the current? Okay, so these currents should be first extracted and they must be converted into the switching commands of the inverter, and which will generate finally these currents at the real power level. So that is the idea. Okay, all right. So now I'll just go through some topologies that you have be familiar, but I will give some more light on that. These topologies could be the single three-phase, three-leg, three-phase, three-phase four-wire, three-phase three-wire, okay, star and delta, all kind of a combinations. So I will describe some of the important topologies. This is one topology which is not practical, where you can use the H-bridge for each phase, and there's an independent DC link voltage. So like BDC1, BDC2, BDC3. Because this will not be economical having the three DC storage capacitors and 12 switches. So it is never used, although it gives the more flexibility in terms of the control. Then we may have the, call it three independent single phase BSI topology. Okay. Now you can see it here. There are three H bridges in the system, and they are independently controlled by each bridge, controlled by each phase concept. However, they have one common DC link. The problem with this topology is this: you cannot handle the DC components, because if this transformer is there, and if you pass the DC component or transformer, will get saturated and the performance will not be good. Then we have a three-phase, three-wire topology. The fourth wire is not being connected to the compensator, although it is a simplistic structure, but it does not compensate the neutral current. So neutral current is directly given to the source, the load to the neutral. You compensate the three-phase. Any rest amount will be passed to the neutral wire. So one way, this is not a very perfect topology to compensate the three-phase four-wire load. Then this is called neutral clamped inverter topology. Now, as you know, the neutral clamped, the neutral of the compensator is being clamped to the neutral of the load and the neutral of the source. You can see that this neutral is coming here and this neutral is coming here, and they are being joined together. Okay, so this neutral. Now, this has a property that if you balance, if you compensate properly, the all neutral current is finally redirected to the inverter. So this will come like this, and come here, and come here, and come here, and finally goes here. So what is left here in this path? Zero current. So for a perfect compensation, the current from this point to this point will be zero, because these three currents are balanced. So if you sum the three balanced current, fundamental frequency, running frequency will be zero except triple harmonics. Okay, so all undesired components are being passed to this point. As if this won't exist, you can say. Even if I disconnect this, it will be fine. But since it is a four-wire configuration, so I have some of the connections. The problem with this topology is this, that there are DC components in the load current. For example, the I0 consists of DC components. Okay, this comes from the nature of the load. Suppose it's a three-phase rectifier, half-wave rectifier. So that creates a significant DC current component. Now the DC current will come here, and when you go inside here, the DC current will be divided, this and this. So what it will do, if the DC current comes here, let us say the current is positive. So what it will do, it will charge the capacitor. But this side, it will discharge the capacitor. So the problem is that the two DC capacitors will develop a different voltage. And once they have a different voltage, even if you have a constant voltage across this whole DC link, but individually, they will not have the same voltage. So that will create problem in compensation that will not provide this satisfactory compensation, because the one DC capacitor having less voltage will not have enough driving force to synthesize the reference current. The other capacitor, which is over voltage, have more capacity to drive the current in the desired direction. And this will make the unsatisfactory compensation. To solve this problem, another scheme has been suggested in literature. In fact, we suggested this scheme in part of our research work. It is called neutral clamped inverter chopper topology. So what problem in the previous configuration was is being solved by using the chopper circuit. So this additional circuit is being used. This already there earlier, we use this additional circuit to address this issue. Okay, so that is being used to transfer the charge from the one having more voltage to the one having less voltage. So these switches S6, S7 and S8 are used to redirect charge in order to balance the voltage across the individual DC capacitors. Now you may ask that what about the overall voltage of DC link voltage, like BDC1 from here to here? This voltage is being maintained by a separate controller, PI controller, okay, which draws a small fraction of active power from the source, from here, so that the total DC link voltage is maintained constant. Normally we use PI controller for this purpose. But the total DC link constant does not mean that individual capacitors will have an equal voltage. So that is being ensured by these two switches. Okay. The more analysis of this system I have given in my papers, so those who are interested can study that part of work. And then comes another important device called DVR, voltage dynamic voltage restorer, which is a complementary device to the DStatCom. In DStatCom, we balance the currents. In DVR, we balance the voltage. Okay, so there are two different aspects of the power quality. And if we use both the devices together, then it becomes the UPQC or Unified Power Quality Conditioner. The idea is very simple in DVR. Okay, the idea is this, that suppose this is my incoming supply, you can see it here. So for a few cycles, the voltage is gone. It is high to reduced to almost 50%, but my device is very sensitive. to this voltage variation, so I need to maintain a constant voltage. So we will inject this voltage to maintain the final voltage as perfect voltage. So this is being injected from this point to this point, and therefore we will have the perfect sinusoidal supply at all the time, irrespective of the disturbances from this time to this time. Now there are many schemes for this also. Theoretically, no compensator must consume the active power. This is the fundamental principle of compensation. Of course, there are losses. So losses have to be replenished. The losses have to be met by, again, the supply, because ultimately the main supply has to do all job, okay? But losses should be minimum, not to nullify the effect of power saving. Suppose you save power by 5% and losses are 10%, then it is not useful anyway. So losses must be less than the amount of saving due to power quality. There is the economics aspect. But conceptually, what we do is this, that we have to add a series voltage. You can see this line in the phasor diagram. Okay, in phase quadrature with the current. If I extend this line like this, this to this point, you can see this angle is 90 degree. In other words, the current which is flowing in this is 90 degree angle with respect to the injected voltage. Okay, so what will be the active power? Active power will be zero, because cos phi is cos 90. That will ensure that there is no real power exchange for the DVR operation. The same thing is also true for D-state comm, that there should not be any manipulation or any requirement of active power except losses, which could be 2 to 5%. So that is an important point. So as you have seen, the basic idea of D-state comm, DVR, and UPQC is a combination of the DVR and D-state comm. And another member of custom power device is solid state circuit breakers or solid state switches. They called SSB also. Okay. In this SSB, the idea is that the controlling is through electronic command, not by the manual operation of the switch, like isolator or you can say a mechanical switch. So it's not mechanical switch, it is simply an electronic switch. And they have their designing to meet the voltage and current rating. You may have shunt or series connections as you saw it here. Okay, so suppose there is some fault. So this fault is to be replaced. Then we will bypass this whole current to this side and we will repair this and come back to supply again. Okay, so this could be more understood by this diagram, in fact, which is using the solid state circuit breaker. So you can see this is a primary source and this is the alternative source, secondary source. And suppose fault takes place here. When fault takes place here, what should be done? The first thing is this, disconnect this switch. Okay, so this I will operate in such a way that this will provide no connection. The power will come from this to this side. Okay, if the fault is, if again the power has come by primary source, then we have to connect to through this side. This is a very normal for our UPSC in our office. If you see in our office UPSC or computer UPSC, this is function they achieve. When there is a power, then the energy has to be derived from the primary source. When primary source is gone, then you switch over to another source called battery inside the EPC. So it is similar to alternative source equivalent to the DC source, a DC source in the DC battery in the UPSC. UPS all uninterrupted power supplies. Okay. So these are the few things that I just wanted to discuss. I think this they have given me 60 minutes, but we have 10 minutes more, so we can have some discussion if you want to have. There are many things, particularly in context of the microgrid systems. Now we are more oriented towards the microgrid research, where we employ these methods to improve the power quality in microgrid, also to allow the proper power exchange between the renewable energy sources and the grid, and the local load connected to the grid. So this flexibility of power flow using the power transmission devices is of very important. Mostly the fundamental rules of control remain same whether you use for microgrid or you use for the power quality. In power quality, the difference is this. In power quality, you are mostly compensating the non-active components, mostly like reactive power or harmonics. You are not talking about the real power exchange. But in case of the microgrid, we are also adding one more feature, is called active power exchange. If you go through control theories, you can define these modes very clearly. We have significant work in this area. Not going to discuss because lack of time, but you can refer our papers, our work, where we have talked about the optimum power exchange between the renewable energy sources, between the grid, and between the load, and between the storage. They are the four important ingredients of the power microgrid based system: the storage, the grid system, the load system, and the renewable sources. And how to make this power flow with the help of the inverter, theories remain same, either PQ or DQ or symmetrical components. Okay, and sometimes use PI controllers. The rest thing is just the integration of all those atoms and having a coordinated way of doing this. So I think you would have enjoyed this presentation, and those basic aspects, maybe they will be useful for further explorations in the application of the microgrid, power quality, the power system. I have not gone into details for sort of time, but I have references you can find out from our website and from the NPTEL book. They have much more detailed version of this. So thank you very much for listening to me. And if you have anything to share, anything to ask, please ask.
Yes. Yes, sir. We have a question, sir. We have a question from Mahanta Gaud Patil, sir. He's asking, for dynamic voltage restorer, why call dynamic system, and what is the control scheme for DVR and STATCOM? If any compensation device is installed in India and in where?
Yeah, there are many schemes. Okay. There are many schemes. Let us call the one is called simply reactive power control scheme, in which there is no active power involved. Then they are called some kind of a phase, phase cottage, they are called phase cottage schemes. Then there are schemes which depend upon the slight exchange of real power. So you may have some battery, you may have some DC storage, or you may have some rectifier. So that allows also the compensation of the
20 minutes cage, madam.
Yeah, tell me.
20 minutes கேச்சு போட்டுமா क्वेश्चन செஷன் முடிஞ்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் போட்டுங்களா
சாய் சார் இஸ் ஆன்சரிங்
yeah that allows the phase jumps and also minimizes the BA rating of the this device. So there are many methods. You can go in literature. Okay, it's not single method. Depending upon the applications and requirements, whether you can afford to exchange real power or not real power, whether the requirement is to compensate deep sag or small sag, whether you want to compensate the phase jump as well. So there are many aspects. I have not looked into that. I just have introduced those are basic thing. But if you want to study, you have to go through these papers or some books.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. We have another question, sir, from Dr. Golapalli Naresh. He's asking where these custom power devices are used in India and their impact on practical system.
Well, there's a lot of, let us say, survey. In India, I think people, as I said in the beginning, they are not mostly used. They are mostly on the research papers. But if you go abroad countries where there is a sensitive process, okay? So sensitive process basically means that you use the semiconductor plants, let us say, or there is a process which is very sensitive to voltage fluctuations, okay? Are very sensitive to the, you know, there is a utility which is sensitive to the harmonics. So on those platforms, they use called custom power park. Their name, particular name called custom power park. So the park basically means, I'm sorry, I have to make this off. So basically park means that there is a set of these devices, maybe UPQC or DBR or something. And there is a, also maybe passive filters, which are being controlled by a central device to take care of any interruptions, any disturbance for the supply of the process plant. Okay. I don't have a specific name right now, but I maybe have some information somewhere where they talk about this. Okay, so you can refer to the literature. But the whole idea is that anywhere there is a sensitive load, where the critical load that won't, you know, accept the any fluctuations in the voltage and current, or which will get disturbed the whole process, which is very costly, like a semiconductor technology or semiconductor plants, where a small disturbance causes a significant loss, these have to be used.
Okay, sir. Thank you for your answer, sir. We have another question from Ravi Kumar McGee. And he's asking, is there is any simple algorithm to voltage regulation with the shunt active filters?
Simple means what? The simplest is simply, I'll tell you, the simplest is to generate that what voltage we want at that particular point, okay? And what voltage is available without any compensation, take the difference, and give the difference as a reference quantity to the compensator and compensate. This is simplest. But it will have its own consequences because you need a lot of synchronization, this and that. So finally, it becomes a complicated process. All active power filters finally becomes a you know, good work on the algorithm implementation. It may look simple from the, you know, direct looking, but it needs a lot of signal processing and synchronization and a lot of protection as well as the safety issues. So nothing is simple as such. It's not that complicated also, but I think if you ask simplicity in formulation, then simplest is just to find out what voltage you want, what voltage is available, take difference and compensate the difference.
Thank you, sir. That was very useful information. And one more question is from Mr. V. Rafi, and he's asking, in Indian 72 and 85 bus system, can you briefly explain how to minimize the losses in that particular kind of system?
What it is that IEEE system?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Well, I'm not in transmission side power system, but any doesn't matter what system you have. My guess is that you have to make out that which loads are the problematic loads at any bus, maybe a 30 bus or 80 bus or whatever bus. So that first we have to see for a given load configurations, what are the problematic buses, where the voltage drops below certain value, or where the harmonic content desired is more. So first the list has to be prepared for a given load. And once we know the characteristic of the load and voltage changes, then we can provide those important places, the devices to compensate. It may be wherever the voltage is going beyond the limit, let's say plus minus 10%, provide the DVR aspect, where the current is drawing more harmonics, provide the current compensator. Actually, this comes under the placement of the FACTS or custom power devices. I think it's a big topic in power system. I am not in that part of research, but we call it placement of the facts or custom power devices. If you talk transmission network, it's a placement of fact devices. So there is a huge research being involved in that where the fax device has to be placed to control it optimally. Okay, maybe you can ask the pure power system, but this is general feeling that I am giving to you.
Yes, sir. I think the questions more onto the transmission part of it rather than the control aspect of it. Anyhow, sir, thanks for your
thank you.
Thanks for your answer, sir.
Participants, is there any other question? Any more questions to be asked, sir? Participant side, is there any more questions yet to be asked?
Sarkumar, if there is no question, Sarkumar, we'll proceed with the next one. Like, what of thanks? I think ma'am can.
Hello, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, what is the control design of DVR, sir?
Control design?
Sir. For mathematical.
Mathematical, I told you there are many methods. Okay. I think one of the methods is given in my book as well, where you find out the voltage at the point of common coupling. Suppose you have a load. Okay. This is one method. So at load, you have to find out that what voltage is desired at that volt at the particular bus. Suppose I want 1.0 per unit. So I will define that voltage first, 1.0 sine omega t.
Okay.
So I know the nominal voltage. Suppose you want balanced voltage, so 1.0 sine omega t, 1.0 sine omega t minus 120, and 1.0 sine omega t plus 120. So this is my reference voltage at the load bus. Now I know that I'm not getting this voltage anyway because of the feeder impedance, because of the disturbance. So our voltage is different. Okay. So how to compensate this? So what happened to happen that this voltage is being fed to the algorithm, okay? And what actual voltage is there? The difference is being calculated.
Awesome.
And the difference is being given to the DVR switching, being converted into switching commands of the DVR through transformer, through filter components, to synthesize that voltage at the in series with the load. So I think it's not really, I will not describe it exactly in the here now in words because it's a lot of mathematics is there. So better, I think you can refer some basic papers. You can refer my this NPTEL book where I have given clear instructions analytically how to do that. There are good examples on that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. I think many students are, many of the participants are asking about the similar resources where we could get your papers and things like that. And I think we will share your link as well.
Yeah, I think on our website also there are given links. So that should not be a problem. And if you have any need paper that you want, my paper, I can always give you whatever copy I have. Okay.
Sure, sir. Thank you. Sai Kumar, can we proceed with the next agenda, Sai Kumar?
Just wait a minute.
Should I sign off?
Just wait a minute, sir. Just wait a minute.
Sir, we'll read out the vote of thanks for you, sir.
Okay, fine.
Sai, can I go ahead with the vote of thanks, Sai?
Just wait a minute, sir. Just ask madam and tell you, sir. 2 minutes, sir.
Okay, sure.
Participants, I have mentioned the feedback link. So kindly join through your college official mail ID and fill the feedback form. It has been posted in the chat box.
Sai, ma'am, did you ask ma'am Sai? Sai Kumar? Sir, just 2 minutes, sir. I think ma'am is having network issues.